guys, Paisteboy here. It's day two, February 27th. It's a Monday, 2023. We're here in wonderful Wallagrass, Maine. Where do you think we're going today, Jim?
We're gonna head south on 85.
Okay.
Go down towards Portage Lake, and then go east on 90 and probably head over to Loring Air Force Base.
Awesome. Sounds like a great adventure.
Border Trail.
Nice.
And then come back and stop for dinner somewhere.
Nice. How many miles do you anticipate roughly we'd put on
today?
Should
be 200 or more.
Excellent.
Today.
All right. Thank you for the insight. Let's hit the trail. much is the fuel here?
$4.69.
It's a buck cheaper than Old Forge. So expensive, an Old Forge is like $5.65 a gallon.
We got some at a place we ate at.
We're doing the
$6 a gallon.
Yep.
I think there's going to be a change of plans on the trail.
Okay.
Because I think there's logging down. So if there is, we'll probably go across the other 73 route, which we got to go across the lake.
Yeah.
On the end, I'm going to look at the map and see, because I don't want to go through the logging again.
Okay.
Not in the bag. I'm going to look at the map and see.
So I wonder if this is super or if it's actually non-ethanol. It says super.
Yeah, it says super non-ethanol.
That would be nice. no idea what trail we're on, but it's I don't know what time it is, but either. So I'm ill-equipped to give you much information other than we've done 35 miles. You could do some miles here pretty quickly because just a lot of trails just keep going. You know what I mean? Even though there are some tight twisties and all that kind of stuff, they're just, it's easier to put on the miles. Like, I think in Old Forge, unless we go out of Old Forge, it takes a long time to, or at least it seems like it does, to put 35 miles on. But there you have it. So, you know, 35 miles. We just pulled over for a quick sec. Just changed the battery on my Insta360. I'm ready to go. Let's reach outdoors,
take it up.
What's that?
I say Paisteboy doing his thing.
That's right. I figured, hey, we stopped.
Yep.
I might as well take out the camera. What do you think of the trail there, boys?
Nice, man.
Right?
Another beautiful day for sure.
Absolutely.
Another bluebird day.
Yeah, and I didn't even start off with a headache either.
You didn't?
No, that's good today. Yeah, I mean, I normally don't. It just yesterday, I think it was the combination of the two-stroke and the smoke. And then it just kind of, you know, set my brain off. And breakfast, yeah, breakfast was... Obviously, it wasn't me smoking, but...
Somebody's got to take over for Zook.
I know, right? Exactly. But, yesterday I just had, like, cereal and an English muffin for breakfast, and my body doesn't like that kind of stuff as much as it wants. It wants some bacon and eggs.
You want the frickin' the hearty breakfast.
Yes, the sustainable breakfast.
Right.
So today was bacon and eggs.
You know, like pancakes and bacon and eggs. And...
Yeah, bacon and eggs is my go-to. Right, buddy?
Yes, sir.
All right. How's the trails for you today?
Lights are softening up a little bit.
Right. Are you wearing a new helmet today? Or did you just tried that out?
No, I'm going to buy it.
You're going to buy it? What is it? What kind of helmet?
I don't know.
Oh, the one you're wearing, the Mission.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah. I hear a lot of good things about that Mission. Now, I thought, the thing that goes over your nose is on the top.
It.
You don't need it?
Good. It'll fog up a bit.
Good.
Perfect.
So you like it?
Oh, yeah.
Awesome. Awesome.
My old helmet used to hitch down a little bit. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I was always doing this, you know?
Yep. Good.
Yeah.
So that's what you're wearing. That was Brad's?
He bought it. His wife didn't like it.
Okay. But you like it.
Oh, my.
I've heard a lot of great things about the Mission helmet.
My windshield's kind of tall, too, so
yeah.
I don't feel any wind.
Good.
Perfect.
Awesome. All right.
And I like, you know, it's got a bigger...
Field of view?
Viewing area,
yeah.
You know?
Yep. Cool. Yeah. All right. I think we're going to head up. We haven't seen any moose yet, which is a good thing.
Uh-huh.
Oh, look at these guys. What are they doing? Caught red-handed.
Nope. The other one.
Is that legal?
What?
Says that legal?
What's that?
Right here,
Just kidding. All right.
In the trees?
Yeah. I think you gotta go, right?
That's right.
All right, let's put some more miles on.
set you up for Rich's reaction here. He just got done riding Greg's Thundercat 1000 Turbo, and it has a special tune on it. It's got Elka shocks and all that. So he has the same sled, just doesn't have the shocks and that specific tune.
Buddy, I have to get that tune, Greg. That, I've never...
The shocks.
Do you know what it reminds me? Oh, it's and the suspension,
it's
too.
Amazing.
You know what that reminds me of? My old crotch rock. That reminds me of an R1 sport bike, buddy.
It's just...
Have you ridden an R1? Greg.
Oh, this thing's shiny, Greg.
Stopped to ask Rich if he knew that he had his scratchers down.
Oh, wow. I had him doing 150, like, to the bar for, like, 5 minutes.
Sleds parked on the side of the trail here look like the two sleds that I've had most recently.
another quick stop here. We're at a closed Air Force base. I believe it's called Lorelei. Not positive of that. I'll put the correct name in print there on the screen. So here it is. It's all our sleds. Well, there's only seven there. Someone took off to do a run down that way because there's like a runway. Apparently this is where they used to keep the B-52 bombers. And there's the tower. I don't know. Can't really zoom in that much here. You might be able to see in that window. Yep, so there's my sled. Yeah, we tried to stop at the Par and Grill closed. And then like everything, because it's Monday, a lot of restaurants are closed Mondays and Tuesdays around here. So basically, we're gonna go back, I think, to the place we went yesterday. It's almost getting dark, sun's setting. We got, I don't know, still got another half of the riding yet to do, but I think we got like 120 miles on so far. So we'll see how it ends up. GoPro got cold because we thought we were stopped to eat, unplugged it. Once you shut off the GoPro in the cold, doesn't want to restart. And so there you have it. And I was trying to preserve the 360 footage, or as far as the battery life. I was on the third battery, so we'll see how that goes once we leave here.
To get dark here.
All right, guys, day two is done. We did 216.5 according to my sled miles today. We didn't end up doing the, New Brunswick there because when we got to the first place that we were going to try to eat, they ended up being closed. So we ended up trying to find a couple other places. Everybody was closed. So we rode more and just ate dinner right before we came back. And we just got back and it's like 10 o'clock at night. So even though I hate night riding.
Let me clarify one thing about night riding. It's not that I dislike riding at night. It's just that if I'm not wearing my glasses, which I normally don't wear my glasses when I ride, it's really hard to see. So therefore, plus with the dust kicking up and it was so cold there, that's what was going on. So it's just difficult for me to see at night. And even though I can wear the glasses now a lot more that I have the oxygen helmet, it's just not perfect scenario every time. So I err on the side of caution and I don't prefer to ride at night.
So even though I hate night riding, we ended up having to do quite a bit of night riding. Couldn't see a damn thing, just following the light on the back of the helmet and pinning it for some of the time. So if you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. Check the links in the description. Go like me, Paisteboy, on Instagram and Facebook. Maybe check out another video after this, and we will see you next time on the trail. Take care.